riding on the city of New Orleans, Illinois Central, Monday morning rail. 15 cars and 15 restless riders.
Stick around for today's video, which is coming up.
Everybody, and welcome back to the Denver and Rio Grande Western Iron Horse Route. This is Brian. Today's video upload is going to be an unboxing, installation, and review of Micro Train's Bettendorf trucks. All right, so in July of 2018, I ordered a Bachmann Yard Boss train set, and it came in, and I set it up, and I loved it. And eventually, I bought some more locomotives and cars, and at that point, when they came in, I learned very quickly that all couplers in N-scale are not created or set to match equally. And so when I did that, I said, I put the brakes on and I started researching. And what I came up with from what I read was that everybody said they either had, wished they had, or wished they had started out from the beginning using micro trains or MTL couplers. And so I opted to do that. And initially, I went with the inexpensive versions, trying to be thrifty. And I ordered these couplers unassembled, and I did them myself, and they took several hours to do. Though they are great couplers, they took a long time and much research to get correct. I had to reach out to people who knew more than me, etc., and so on. So I converted the locos, and I converted one of the cars, and then I remembered in my reading that I researched something, and I saw something, I'd learned about something called a Bettendorf truck. And these trucks were already assembled. They had the coupler and the wheels. They came with a pin. They plugged right in. They were advertised basically as plug and play. I figured out for just a little bit more money, I could get these MTL couplers on my car. They'd be professionally put together and could be mounted real easy. And that way, you know, any derailment problems and things like that, I could pretty much more attribute to some of the problems with track work or something like that and not have to worry so much about it being the couplers. Because, you know, with a beginner like me, with the track problems that I encounter sometimes, I need to know where my problems are. Story short, I ordered some Bettendorf trucks. They came in and they were awesome. I loved them. And after playing with them a little bit, I decided that they were the bee's knees and I was gonna stick to them. And so I ordered three more sets and they came in the mail the other day. Next, I'm gonna walk you through the opening, the installation, and then give you a review.
Right, so I ordered the conversions for my F7 as well as a Lifelike locomotive and some Concord cars. And what I'm showing you right now is really quick, but these are the instructions for the unassembled coupler. If that tells you anything, like I said, about 3 to 5 hours, had to reach out to a lot of people. These are the Bettendorf trucks, okay? The Bettendorf trucks arrive now, and we are happy to have them, very happy to have them. And,
I'm using the brown short shank version of the Bettendorf truck. They also come in black, medium, and long shank versions.
It contains a truck, it contains two pins, a shim, as well as plastic wheels. Now, the plastic wheel set is the only thing that I have to complain about in this entire deal. I do go ahead and change those out for an MTL 33-inch wheel set. I'll show you the package and the item number on that at the end of the video. And basically just in the palm of my hand, just kind of showing you now. It comes with a fully assembled magnematic coupler, which can, you know, for automatic uncoupling. Down the road, maybe I'll be able to do that. It's something I'm not concerned with at all now, but from what I've read, it's better for me to go ahead and have them and not use them than not have them and wish I did down the road. So just kind of, again, showing you everything. It does come with actually two different size pins as well as a shim and a filler hole kind of for a... If you have a screw, so actually it's three different kind of pins, and basically they just push straight in, unless of course you do have a car that has a screw-in truck, and then you're actually going to have to do some slight modifications. And here I'm just going to show you actually how easy and quickly it is to do a car. I have a that's a 3 1/4 inch Rio Grande 3 tri-hopper, if I'm not mistaken, and I'm gonna have to adjust the weights on those. I'm gonna do a video on that coming up as well. But basically, you know, once I determine that the which pin I need, I'm just gonna line it up, make sure the wheels are in good and that they're rolling well, and then I'll pop the pin in. And basically what I have found up to this point is that for the most part, I'm finding that they're coming coupled pretty much at the right height using this particular pin, one of the two pins that comes automatically with it. What I do if I pull the pins off with my hand, I do put a little sandpaper around the tip of my finger there, like I'm showing you now, and I just pop the burr off of it. If I clip it off with the straight edge clippers, like the rail nippers, and I do a good enough job, that's not necessary. And I'm just going to show you both ways to do that now. Not rocket science, obviously, but all I do is I just find it easier to use the tweezers and to get it lined up, and then actually I can just use my pressure down. Again, I try not to get it too tight. I do want a little space. I want it to move freely, but I don't want it to wobble. And so that's what I'm after. That's what I've read I'm supposed to be after. And now I'll show you the next one. Now, what I want to tell you is that I've already completed installing one of the trucks and couplers over there. Now, the first time I did that, it was the dreaded 1128, which I'm going to do a video on down the road, because I have figured out how to do that due to Mike Pfeiffer's help. Thanks, Mike. Ron Marsh's help. Thanks, Ron. And as well as Steve actually helped me with a couple coupler questions as well. Steve Brown from Trax Mac. Appreciate that, too. All right. And so I'm checking the wheel site, and they're in, bud. That's it. All right, what took me 4 hours the first time I did it to do one, all right, took me exactly that long to do two, or a whole car, which is $5 instead of about $2. And in my opinion, until I get a whole lot better, or a whole lot more cars that need to be done at a time, I'm fortunate enough where I'm going to go ahead and just get the assembled Bettendorf trucks. Now, I use this MT height gauge. This is a Microtrains height gauge. It's a 6-in-1 tool.
This tool is essential and a must-have for any layout at $8. It serves as a coupler height gauge, trip pin height gauge. It also serves as a wheel width gauge and a track width gauge. I can also use it if my track gets out of gauge to get it back in with the heating the rails.
This tool will also serve as a jig in a certain situation as well. Right now I'm just checking coupler heights. Again, I have converted 6 cars total now, all of which with the Bettendorf trucks matched up perfectly, none of which that I did on my own the first time matched up perfectly. Again, I ended up doing it successfully, but it took a lot of time. And so, bam, that's all there is to it, guys. And it lines up, and it's right, lines up there. Now all I do is flip it over, okay? And I can check the pin. And I don't know that that's called pin. I'm going to have to check that, because I'm not using the right word there at all. I knew it just a minute ago, but it escapes me now. Basically just showing you that's how easy it is to check and make sure everything's cool. There's all 5 cars done.
Here's a look at the packaging that I used for the metal wheel sets I replaced the plastic ones with. Thank you for stopping in and hanging out and watching the Bettendorf video today. I'd like to encourage you to subscribe and click the bell icon if you haven't already. Speaking of, check back in with me on Friday if you want to see these 5 cars in action. We're going to put them on the track. We're going to get them running. We're going to do a layout tour. If I can't get them running, we're going to do a video as to why they're not running. We'll check back Friday. I look forward to getting with y'all then. Brian with the Denver and Rio Grande Western Iron Horse Route, signing off.
Rocky Mountain High.